Sign in with Ethereum is a game changer for Web3 users. It opens door for Web3 dApps to truly become decentralized and get rid of present centralized giants to be used for user authentication. Hey everyone! Welcome to Ether World. Today we will discuss about sign in with Ethereum. Before deep diving into sign in with Ethereum, let's discuss SSO, that is, the single sign-on approach. It is an authentication scheme where users can securely authenticate and gain access to multiple apps and websites by only logging in with a single username and password. For example, if we talk about Web2 world, logging into a Google account will give users access to Google apps such as Docs, Gmail, Drive and much more. The advantages of the SSO approach are: 1. No need to remember user ID and password for different websites. 2. Convenient for users to log in multiple website with one sign-in. In present Web2 world, one provider may not solve all the problems because 1. We have multiple SSO options. 2. All these Web2 organizations ask for a lot of user data, that is, location, date of birth, phone number, etc., and much more. 3. In case of a data breach, all the user's personal information is leaked. Hopefully, by now you will have a good idea about the importance of SSO. Let's move on to sign in with Ethereum. It is a new way of authentication that enables users to control their digital identity with their Ethereum account and ENS profile instead of relying on a traditional intermediary. Let's take a look at the difference between the present Connect wallet versus sign in with Ethereum. In the present Connect wallet scenarios, dApps do not remember anything about the user and the same experience is provided to him every time he logins. But users want a better experience when they visit the same dApp for the next time. For example, Uniswap remembers his favorite trading pair, Aave remembers his favorite lending markets, etc., and much more. However, users have to restart every time they connect their wallet. But with this sign-in option, the login is saved after authenticating with dApps and establishing a session. Even if the user disconnects and authenticates again, everything is still remembered about him on the application. It will save users' information in a remote data vault he controls. Let's take a closer look at EIP-4361, which implements the concept of sign-in with Ethereum. It describes how Ethereum accounts authenticate with off-chain services by signing a standard message format parameterized by scope, session details, and security mechanisms, that is, a nonce. The proposal aims to provide an alternative to centralized identity providers, improve interoperability across off-chain services for Ethereum-based authentication, and provide wallet with a consistent machine-readable message format to achieve improved user experiences and consent management. It offers a new self-custodial option for users who want more control and responsibility over their digital identity. Here is how sign-in with Ethereum looks like. Here is a skeleton of how a typical sign-in with Ethereum message. Now, we will understand each of these fields one by one. 1. Domain, authority that is requesting the sign-in. 2. Address, user's Ethereum address. 3. Statement, human-readable message. 4. Version, current version of the message. 5. Chain ID, used in transaction signing process for protection against transaction replay attacks. 6. Nonce, a randomized token to prevent replay attacks. 7. Issued at, current date and time. 8. Expiration time, date and time when the signed authentication message is no longer valid. 9. Not before, date and time when the signed authentication message will become valid. 10. Request ID, system-specific identifier that uniquely refers to the sign-in request. 11. Resources, list of information or references to information the user wishes to have resolved as part of authentication by the relying party. For novice users, it is comforting to know that sign-in with Ethereum doesn't involve any gas costs to end users. It's just signing a message that doesn't create any blockchain transaction. As of the publishing of January 2023, EIP-4361 has implementations in 6 programming languages: TypeScript, Rust, Go, Python, Elixir, and Ruby. We hope to see sign-in with Ethereum adoption to multiple dApps in near future. If you want to learn about Ethereum accounts and externally owned account also known as EOA, check out our videos. Subscribe Etherworld YouTube and website for easy to learn Ethereum blockchain concepts. Appreciate your support. Thank you.